The Lord shall fight for you. One time I had to quit a job, but I was in a bond period. I did not complete bond, but I did not take the experience certificate then itself. I thought maybe I will not require it. So I didn't pay the bond period and they didn't give me experience certificate and I left. But after 2 years, I wanted to work again and I thought of getting this experience certificate from this company. They said as per the bond, you have to pay 2 lakhs. So if you pay, we will give you the experience certificate. It was a big money, but still I wanted to be right in the sense like, put the right experience in the right way. So if it is as per the bond I have to pay, I thought it's right to pay. So I have paid the amount. I was in Bangalore and this company was in Hyderabad. So I was talking over the emails and phone. Only one time when I had to ask about this certificate experience, I went to Hyderabad and then in the office they told that this is the procedure, you pay for the organization in check and then for this department and then we will give you the experience certificate. I have paid, but the day when I have to receive the experience certificate, when I emailed them and called them, they said, why are you expecting an experience certificate from us? You will not get any such certificate. Legally, you should pay us the bond money and you paid. That's it. And I was so shocked because there is no legal case on me or anything. No one asked me to pay till the time I asked for the experience certificate. Why would I just like that pay that much amount, right? And the same people who spoke that this is the procedure to receive the experience certificate, when they said this, I was so upset, I was so angry. And the other side, actually I got another job and I need this certificate to give to this to join to in the other company. And that is this kind of situation, tension and angry one side. And for a moment I felt like something bad should happen to this guy and he should know the God should do something, teach him a lesson by something should happen and he should understand that because he did this to me, it happened. But then God spoke to me how that thinking was wrong, and I have repented about it. The word says that God reminded me that we should love the enemies and bless those who persecute us. We should not curse, right? So I have repented. There was a friend with me that time who came to visit. We both sat down and fasted and prayed about this matter. By evening, I have to submit to the new company, I thought. And in this situation, as God spoke, I have repented about it and started to bless this person. Me and my friend, we both started literally blessing his family who did this and him, and pray for his salvation and his for him to have good life and all that. And also we fasted about God intervention in this matter and to guide us. And by evening, exactly before we ended the fasting itself, I got an email from another HR from this department who knows the matter. Probably God gave him kind heart towards me. So this guy kept an email saying, see, I am sending this email without other people knowing it. So you don't have to mention about this email, but this is the email address I am giving of a senior authority. You may email him saying what all this situation, and if he says one word, you will get your experience letter. And immediately I kept an email to him, and within 30 minutes or less than an hour, I received my experience certificate soft copy. That is how God, I saw how he really intervenes and fights for us. there is another example of how I was having a tough manager in one of my job. It was not too long, but one day he shouted in the meeting on me for something very silly. Like, it's not needed. It was very clear that it was about me working with someone who he hates. So that day I felt very sad the way, because he shouted. That is the time, even though he was, I know that he doesn't like my timings and all, I was not worried anytime, but that day a few drops of tears came when I was walking back home. And then in that tears, like, I told God, you are with me, right? And you are going to take care of this matter. I don't know how I am going to work under him further like this. And the matter somehow went to the authorities that he is talking to people not to work as a team. And they have immediately, the next day itself, moved him from this project to another project, not as a manager, but as a team member. Only when we know that God is in control, or how much we believe and trust in him, our words and the actions we take, they reflect that. So, and we will see for sure, because God is so faithful. Faithful is the name, another name of Jesus. And he cannot be unfaithful. So he is faithful to all his promises. And when we make sure that we fall in line with that word, definitely what is supposed to happen as per that will happen. As I said, for example, when I gave another testimony about how he provides our needs, you know, when we seek his kingdom and his righteousness first, the other things must follow, because that is the promise of God. That is how the promises will work. There is nothing that God himself will not do. If something is not happening, it is something we have to align or see where we can ask God. Even that, God will show us what is something that we have to change, or maybe one of our belief is wrong, or what we are asking is wrong, or is it the wrong timing, or something will be there which we have to correct or we have to change. But God and himself is truthful, and all his promises are true. Thank you for listening.